Over the last couple of years, we've seen SpaceX go from a dirt field in Texas to launching prototypes of the most advanced rocket ever made. The exciting developments down in Boca Chica have been mesmerizing to watch, and it's clear that SpaceX are now all in on making Starship a success. In the future, they plan to have a fleet of Starships, launching all around the world with destinations such as the Moon, Mars and even other places here on Earth. They want to operate Starship just like an airliner, with each vehicle carrying hundreds of passengers and doing multiple flights per day. But many think this exciting future is just too good to be true. Upon launch, a fully assembled Starship will be incredibly loud. With around 28 Raptor engines on the Super Heavy booster, the sound level, even from 8 kilometers away, would be around 112 decibels. This is like someone using a chainsaw while standing right next to you. Not only would this sound level be extremely disruptive to nearby residents, it could also be extremely dangerous. The closer to Starship you get, the sound waves become powerful enough to smash windows and damage buildings. If Starship launches are to be as frequent as SpaceX hope, they will need to move then launch and landing pads far away from civilization. Early renders of Starship show a sleek-looking launch platform several miles offshore. The idea is that Starships would launch and land from these platforms without ever having to go back to dry land. SpaceX is repurposing oil rigs to build a Starship spaceport that will be in operation in 2022. The aerospace company purchased two oil rigs, named them Phobos and Deimos, like the moons of Mars. The oil rigs are currently located in South Texas at the Port of Brownsville, which is close to SpaceX's Starbase facility where Starship is under development. The spacecraft will require a gigantic Super Heavy rocket booster to propel it to orbit, because the launch system will be very noisy. Launching from a spaceport at sea far from cities will be the best option to conduct frequent trips. Ocean Spaceport Deimos is under construction for launch next year. The oil rig is currently undergoing refurbishment. It features a helicopter pad with its name in yellow letters. The spaceport is expected to feature a giant launch tower that will be capable of supporting the booster, as it returns from space. Engineers aim to develop a fully reusable Starship, Super Heavy launch vehicle, capable of being reused at least 3 times a day. Super Heavy must be capable of being rapidly reusable. For that purpose, SpaceX will design a launch tower that could quickly catch the booster after it launches the Starship spacecraft to orbit. We're going to try to catch the Super Heavy booster with the launch tower arm, using the grid fins to take the load, Musk said. The company's Falcon 9 rocket also features grid fins, which are used to control the vehicle as it descends. Engineers will utilize the same feature for Super Heavy but modify it to support the vehicle's landing. But even in the world of spaceflight, this isn't a new idea. The company, Sea Launch, which started back in the 90s, specialized in launching the Zenit rocket from a floating sea platform which used to be a former oil rig. Although it may seem like quite a small operation, this was no small rocket. The Zenit was almost the same size as the Falcon 9 and could carry a similar amount of mass into orbit. In its day, Sea Launch was pretty successful. But high running costs and a lack of flights eventually caused them to go bankrupt. However, Sea Launch demonstrated that there are a lot of benefits to launching from the sea. When launching from typical launch sites like Cape Canaveral, rockets aren't allowed to fly over populated areas, so they usually head out over the sea. This drastically limits the range of orbits it can achieve. For geostationary orbits, rockets need to fly perfectly above the equator and travel with the rotation of Earth. This means that the rocket spends much more of its fuel just getting down to the equator. When launching from a sea platform, any orbit can be achieved. This isn't the main consideration for SpaceX, but with their constantly growing Starlink constellation, an offshore launch platform would help them to reach a much wider range of orbits and cover the globe with their satellites. We saw various job postings from SpaceX looking to hire engineers and technicians for offshore launch platforms. After all, with the incredible pace of Starship's development, an offshore launch platform could be needed much sooner than expected. Just several miles away from their Boca Chica site is the Port of Brownsville, home to many oil rigs which operate out in the Gulf of Mexico. If SpaceX were working on a future launch platform, it would most likely be happening here. Sure enough, at the start of this year, one specific oil rig caught everyone's attention. Sitting amongst the tanker ships in the Port of Brownsville was an oil rig sporting the name Deimos, a moon of Mars. After further investigation, this oil rig used to be owned by a company called Valeris, which went bankrupt in 2020. After declaring bankruptcy, they sold this oil rig along with another identical rig to a company called Lone Star Mineral Development. The other oil rig was also named after a Martian moon and resided in a port elsewhere in Texas. Lone Star managed to purchase Deimos and Phobos for just $3.5 million each, a great price considering these rigs cost $515 million to build. But who was the mysterious company behind this transaction? Well, as it turns out, Lone Star Mineral Development is a subsidiary of SpaceX. This confirms that SpaceX are going ahead with their offshore launch platform idea. But how will SpaceX convert these oil rigs to be able to launch and land Starships? To get a better idea, let's take a closer look at the rigs SpaceX have just purchased. These rigs are semi-submersible and can be moved out to sea and anchored in place. With large ship-like hulls placed well below the surface, these rigs are much more stable and less affected by waves than SpaceX's current drone ships. Each rig is 73 by 78 meters wide and has 8 thrusters, each producing around 3,500 horsepower. Since these rigs operate many miles out at sea, they rely on their own power, which in this case is provided by 7 enormous diesel engines. But since Elon Musk is at the helm of this project, it seems likely that these will be taken out and replaced with a more renewable form of energy, like wind or solar. Before SpaceX can start customizing these rigs for Starship, they will need to take down a lot of the existing structures that were used to support the drilling equipment. Dismantling an oil rig is a costly but very common thing to do, once it reaches the end of its life cycle. Judging by SpaceX's previous renders, the launch platform will be fairly simple on top. They need a large space for the landing area, a tank farm to store propellants and a large crane to lift and stack Starship. The large tower in the middle, known as a derrick, was used to support all of the heavy drilling equipment. At first it may seem like this tower could be used zero as the foundations for the massive lifting crane. But underneath this tower is the moon pool, which is essentially a giant hole in the platform. During launch, the energy produced by Starship's engines will be extremely powerful. So SpaceX will want to direct as much of that energy into the sea, where it will be absorbed instead of damaging the launch platform. It seems likely that SpaceX will use this moon pool to their advantage and build the launch mount on top, allowing the engines to sit above the water. SpaceX will also need to build an entire tank farm to contain the enormous amounts of propellants used for flight. Then there is the question of how SpaceX would actually get the propellants to the launch platform. The main propellants for Starship are liquid oxygen and liquid methane. Right now, these propellants are currently transported to Boca Chica by truck, where they are unloaded into the tank farm. In order to keep the launch platform filled up, they will rely on regular deliveries from tanker ships. Right now, SpaceX is working on a brand new facility in Boca Chica which will allow them to start producing their own propellants. In order to produce a large amount of propellant, these facilities need to be extremely large and require a huge amount of energy. SpaceX's short-term plan is to produce their own liquid oxygen from the launch platform while the liquid methane would be delivered by a tanker ship. In the future though, SpaceX wants to use the SABATIER process to produce their own propellants. This process involves turning hydrogen and carbon dioxide into oxygen and methane, something SpaceX will need to do to produce propellants on Mars. Getting to this point will be very challenging for SpaceX, but the lessons they learn along the way will help them prepare for their first trips to Mars. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.